1953. He came home from work and he had quite a load. He was working out in Lewisport, tired of the road. He came home to see Mary and his wee kitty Sue. Walked in the door and he smelled the homebrew. Sitting at the table was his young brother Dan, a smile on his face and a drink in his hand. "Well, what's that you're drinking?" said Rich with a grin. "Sit down, me by, and have some Japanese gin. It's wonderful good, will cure all your ills. You'll have no cause for doctors and all of their bills." Well, they had a few drinks, a few stories they told. The days at the ice and the wind and the cold. After they drank another one down, they thought up the spots that were still in the ground. Well, the spots must come up before the first frost. If not, they would spoil and the crop would be lost. He went to the barn and he opened the stall. To haul in the spots, he would need his mare Moll. Now Rich and Dan were digging up the spots that were there. Started to feel their legs getting queer. Rich said to Dan with a silly old grin, "Let's have one more drink of that Japanese gin." Well, they filled up two barrels and they had lots of trouble. Counted up four, they were both seeing double. They loaded old Moll to the cellar they started. The mare gave a yank and with that she darted. Well, Richie fell down and Dan he did too. Moll, she tipped over and the spuds how they flew. Then the boy's father came out through the door. He looked at the mare and he started to roar. Now poor old Moll, she was caught in the trees. Old Rich and Dan, they were down on their knees. Caught in the bushes, cause she was pretty stout. And Rich yelled at Dan, "By, she'll never get out." Now the boys sobered up later on the next day. Thought up the spuds that were frozen in clay. Rich looked at Dan and he said, "It's a sin. We lost all our spuds from drinking that gin. Come all you good people who dig spuds in the fall. Let this be a lesson to you one and all. Make sure you're sober before you begin. And boys, stay away from that Japanese gin. 'Cause you can't dig potatoes while drinking that gin."